Hi, let's talk about the Azygos system. In this video, we'll discuss the Azygos venous system, as well as the pattern of venous drainage of the right and left intercostal spaces. When we consider the venous drainage of the thorax, there are two challenges that I think are illustrative of what evolution has really overcome. The first is that we have a heart that is going to occupy the mediastinum. Now, when we think about that, what that really means is that in that space of the heart, there is no caval access for any of the posterior intercostal veins. We have the superior and inferior vena cavae draining into the right atrium of the heart, and those posterior intercostal veins have no direct access. The second challenge is that the superior vena cava within the mediastinum is going to be one of the most anteriorly oriented pieces of vasculature, and those intercostal veins are going to have their greatest drainage into the posterior intercostal veins, which would have to be conveyed through the entire depth of the mediastinum to get to the superior vena cava. So it's quite amazing what evolution and development have overcome in order to drain the thorax. Their solution is the Azygos system. Azygos comes from the root words A, meaning knot, and zygus, meaning yoked. So yoked as in two oxen being yoked together. So in essence, this is an unpaired system, and it is not written A. So there is no U in Azygos. The Azygos system is what conducts the majority of blood from the walls of the thorax. It's extraordinarily variable, and so we'll discuss the main patterns of drainage of the Azygos system. And that main pattern is pretty straightforward. We have an Azygos vein, which I will highlight now. Circle. Here is that Azygos vein, and it's going to drain into the superior vena cava. That Azygos vein drains the majority of the intercostal spaces and subcostal spaces of the right thorax, as well as regions of the lumbar with blood or of blood. And then on the left side, we have an accessory hemiazygous vein, which drains this region that I have circled. So the accessory hemiazygous, or the AHA vein, and then we have the hemiazygous vein, which is going to drain the inferior portions of the thorax as well as the lumbar regions of blood. So we have the accessory and the hemiazygous veins. And I always recall that accessory is superior because A comes before H in the alphabet. So let's take a look at a little more granular detail here to see what we can see. Going into the Azygos vein, tributary-wise, let's begin on the right. Intercostal spaces 2, 3, and 4 are going to be drained via common trunk. This is the superior intercostal vein, the right superior intercostal vein. And then intercostal spaces 5 through 11, as well as the subcostal vein, as well as the right ascending lumbar vein, will all drain into the Azygos vein. But the Azygos vein has two more tributaries coming from the left side, the accessory hemiazygous and the hemiazygous. That accessory hemiazygous typically drains intercostal spaces 5 through 8, whereas the hemiazygos is going to drain intercostal spaces 9 through 11, plus subcostal, plus ascending lumbar. The accessory hemiazygos and hemiazygos veins typically are going to drain directly into the azygos vein, but sometimes they may form a common trunk, and that trunk may drain into the azygos vein. Or you might see neither of these veins, and those posterior intercostal veins may drain directly into the azygos system. Either way. So there are a few non-azygos tributaries, and let's deal with them intercostal space by intercostal space. The first intercostal spaces are probably the simplest. So the first intercostal spaces are drained by the supreme intercostal veins. Right and left supreme intercostal veins are going to drain the first intercostal space, and they may drain either directly into their ipsilateral, that means same side, brachiocephalic veins, as we can see here, or they may also drain into their ipsilateral vertebral veins, which the vertebral veins are going to be branches of the subclavian veins. And the one on the right might also branch directly into the superior vena cava. The second through fourth intercostal spaces are drained through the superior intercostal veins. So supreme is above the superior intercostal veins. On the right side, intercostal spaces 2 through 4 are drained into the azygos, specifically into the arch of the azygos vein. Whereas on the left side, that left superior intercostal vein is typically going to drain into the left brachiocephalic vein. And recall that that left brachiocephalic vein is very long and very oblique as it travels across the superior mediastinum. So we've discussed the challenges involved in returning blood into the caval system within the thorax. We've discussed the pattern of venous drainage of the thorax, namely the azygos system and its major tributaries, intercostal veins, as well as accessory hemiazygos and hemiazygos veins. This is your summary slide. Thank you for your time.